And thank you very warmly, Madam Senator Laurel Lezama-Leasing, for your very kind introduction in your capacity as Master of Ceremonies of this traditional PNM operation. Traditional began back in the days with Dr. Williams, and it continued, and we under Dr. Keith Rowley would continue it. Thank you very much. Let me recognize in the formality our political leader, the Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley, our leader. Deputy Political Leader, Madam June Yule Williams. It's always a joy, always a pleasure learning from you, pressing on with the business of the PNM. My parliamentary and cabinet colleagues, the Minister of Finance, Mr. Colman Bird, Member of Parliament for Dago Martin Northeast, and of course, Minister Young, Minister of Energy, Member of Parliament for Port of Spain, North St. Anne's West, and I recognize other cabinet colleagues, Minister Marvin Gonzales, the Attorney General Faris Al-Rari, and all others listening around the place. Local government representatives present, officers of the movement, members of the PNM, members of the media, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, as I said, in this strong PNM tradition, we come to you to speak on national issues, matters that would have taken place since our last budget presentation, the 2021 budget, and of course, the projections into the future. We listen today to that lady as she slurred and stumbled and wobbled through the speech written to her. Written for her. You may not have seen it, but they provided a chair in the speaker's enclosure for her today, and there was a technique on the part of her minions. Every time we throw a little crosstalk, they would jump up and gain the attention of the speaker to give her extra time to sit down in the corner to get her wounds attended to like a boxer. Except, of course, she can't box. Calamity Jane, you know, a distraction in disconsonance with the reality of Trinidad and Tobago, and equally wicked, in my view, a bugbear. I listened to her presentation today as she stumbled through, casting aspersions on the Attorney General, on the Minister of Finance, Minister Young, on yours truly. That's all they're good at, with no facts. When we were in opposition and we responded to a budget, you will remember Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. Rowley, the Minister of Finance, yours truly, we always had something useful to add because their bad behavior was like low-hanging fruit. But for 6 years, they've been responding to our budgets, and you would notice today not a single serious, sustainable argument about any untoward behavior on the part of ministers of this cabinet and this government. That's the reality. She describes the whole budget as a typo. You know why? Because every time the Minister of Finance talking about revenue mentioned the word VAT, she expects to see 19 after it. The woman could hardly pronounce words. I was embarrassed. And no doubt if she saw Johnny Walker, she might say Johnny Runner. I wanted to run from she too. I'm embarrassed. But that is Calamity Jane. I propose, like Minister Young, to speak a little bit on the way the measures of the last year impacted powerfully and positively on the people I represent in Lavantil West. But Lavantil is not a place, it's an experience. And I consider Lavantil, if you take the geography from Queen's Park East by Gillingham Avenue, all the way to the Kwesi, all those hills and lands and valleys and hills. That's love until as far as I concern. No wire fence. When they come to me, I see all, I attend to all, because we are the children. And so it will be. We come here tonight, as we always have done, to account for the way we made use of your money. Dr. Williams told us many years ago that education is the poor man's bank account. I listened to the young and beautiful and bright Dr. Nyan Gatsby-Dolly today as she elucidated upon the measures that we have put in place in this very difficult economic time, in this COVID-stricken environment, for the benefit of the children and future generations of Trinidad and Tobago. GATE is well established because of our financial circumstances. They have put in a means test, but we still hold true to the philosophy that no one will be denied of an opportunity on the basis of a lack of money. The primary schools are still available compulsorily, and secondary schools for all of the children of this nation. And many of you across this nation have made great opportunity from that access all across the land. But for Laventille, the Prime Minister directed that we put a special education plan in place for the 25 schools of Laventille, 21 primary schools and 4 secondary schools. They were given special attention in the last year and reported some successes in so doing. You would have heard Minister Young, Minister Gatsby-Dolly today talk about devices. I too mobilized for Laventille West and got private contributors, whether it was Angostura, whether it was Wayne Harriet's company, who came in and donated $140,000 worth of laptops and devices for the children of Laventille. Whether it was from the East Port of Spain Development Company, and more recently from the HDC. Minister Gatsby-Dolly would have told you today that some 43,000 laptops were made available, 23,000 from the private sector, and the government, with the authority of the cabinet, led by the Prime Minister, purchased 20,000 units and made them available to the children, including the children of Laventille. So today, the children have access to online education. It is not perfect. Nobody planned the COVID experience, but it is happening, and we are exerting best efforts in so doing. Huawei contributed as well, and we are very happy and proud of that. All in addition to 10,000 MiFi devices, if you want to call it that, where if you did not have internet access in your home for any reason, this MiFi device, your Wi-Fi, could provide internet access wherever you are. That is where we spent some of your money to ensure that the future of the country is secure. In terms of urban renewal, Laventille, East Port of Spain, right now UDCOT is engaged in plans to do a massive urban redevelopment project, something started by Dr. Williams back in the day. Dr. Rowley was Minister of Housing. One of the best set of apartments you will find anywhere in this country are those in Clifton Towers in the back there behind Bessor Street Police Station for the people of Laventille. And I remember when he opened it, Dr. Rowley called on the people to respect and appreciate this beautiful edifice. This wonderful effort on the part of the government to provide you with a place to call your own and to call home, and treat it with respect and live in harmony with each other. Don't hang clothes all over the place on the banister and make it look like no slum. Those were the words. I remember them well. And thankfully, the majority of the people have lived up to that. Not that we didn't have some difficulty, but those matters we'll treat with. And so the urban redevelopment plan is underway. In the process, Desperados Steel Orchestra, the mecca of steel bands from the hills of Laventille, they can anticipate a pan theater and auditorium where they can host income-earning concerts and shows for people who would come. And it is not only for their use. The Prime Minister visions that all stars could use it if they want, renegades could use it if they want, and the entire Pan family could showcase what we created in Love and Till, following in the tradition of Dr. Williams, who found them in the 60s and 70s, sponsors for those bands, realizing the great talent that these men and women who created this instrument can produce to the joy and the uplift of the entire world. And that continued in 2021 and will continue into the foreseeable future. Minister Young spoke about, well, before that, Cabinet approved recently a building off the old St. Joseph Road by Parsley Street corner. It will be refurbished, it will be refitted, and it will be purpose-built for three cultural organizations of strong Love and Till vintage. Malik Folk Performers, Marcia Charles Dance Company, and Northwest Love and Till Cultural Movement. Cabinet agreed, and arrangements were made for it to be handed to them. Now it's about raising the necessary finances for its refurbishment and to create a home of culture. Because as you all know, Love and Till is not blessed with any large expanses of land, any fishing ports, and all of the natural things that will generate industries, agriculture, and what have you. Love and Till has always had the benefit of the strong human spirit and talent. And in recognition of that, we contribute to that development for the benefit of all and the joy of all the people of Trinidad and Tobago and the world. Vaccines. Last Saturday, I was on the Beetham. Again, previously, the Prime Minister mandated every one of us in the cabinet in his loving, caring, paternalistic, nation-loving spirit. He said the national program that we are running for vaccines is great. I remember when we had to use the Air Guard to go Grenada to get a few, Barbados to get a few more, Bermuda. We did that, St. Vincent. But the Prime Minister said, and we spent money, we went into the COVAX system, he said, that is not enough. I want every one of you as members of Parliament to establish your own program for your people. And we did that in Love and Till East Mova. We established 3 sites, and we had an all-day operation. And the people responded positively. Many more had their vaccines to ensure that they remain healthy and whole and well, so that they can benefit from the outpourings of Mother Trinidad and Tobago as we envisage it. And last Saturday, the people of Beetham called me. They said, look here, some of us wasn't aware of it. We went in, we mic'd every single street on the Beetham for 2 days, and we gathered them together last day. And I visited, and I saw young people, young men, young women coming forward. One young man told me his father and mother didn't want him to take the vaccine, but he wanted to take it. He came there, he got his shot, and he quietly went away. Sometimes wisdom is found in the simplest of places, in the nick of time. And out of the mouths and the spirits of babes and sucklings cometh wisdom. Can't get away from that. So we did that. You all will know we celebrated the establishment of a modern, world-class swimming pool in the Love and Till area, Sobrin Trace for more specificity. And the Prime Minister recognizing that today, while I think he could swim, but for those of us who can't swim, Tobago man, he must be able to do that. For those of us who can't do that, you could go to that pool now and you would see COVID interfered with the program, but the Coast Guard, who the Prime Minister mandated take responsibility for that plant and to teach the children, the Coast Guard stood proudly aside. I watched 10-year-olds, 9-year-olds swimming 2 lengths of the pool in real semi-professional standing. And we know that one day, we'll produce a national swimmer, and we've produced that in Mova and Love and Till already, but a world-class swimmer from that pool, right up in the hole in Love and Till. And the Prime Minister said, if it's nice, you must do it twice. He mandated UDCOT again to establish another one for the people of Love and Till / Mova in the Coconut Drive area. And that pool, Prime Minister, is now complete and awaiting your arrival, sir. (Clears throat) Water looking blue and better than the water in Castarias. Minister Young touched on it. It's close to my heart. When we formed this government in 2020, after we devastated that stumbling, wobbling, slurring woman and her bunch of crooks, when we dealt with them in 2020 and we went back to government, the Prime Minister, with a spirit and a heart for the young people, established the Ministry of Youth Development and National Service, and I was honored to be asked to shape it, to lead it, and I did that until the Prime Minister told me otherwise. Minister Cummins has now gone in, and I sit in admiration on a daily basis at the level of energy and enthusiasm that he has put inside of this. He keeps the Minister of Finance, the Minister of Planning, who is central, quiet, you know, but central to all of this, very engaged on a weekly basis, looking for the ways to get on with the programs that we have established in there so that the youth can benefit of it, from it. Recognizing the value of agriculture in all of this, the youth must be told and must be reminded, including the Lavantil youth, that agriculture is a tax-free environment. If you get into the business, the industry of agriculture, no taxes will be met with you. Anything you make is profit. And we went out to the people of Lavantil and we told them that, and I can tell you happily and almost boastfully, ladies and gentlemen, that Dr. Rowley again mandated that the seed bank, the National Seed Bank, produce over 1 million seedlings, plantlings, and seeds, high quality seeds. And we distributed thousands of packets of those seeds all over Trinidad and Tobago, including Lavantil. And I can tell you, as I promised you a minute ago, if you go, I can carry you to places in Lavantil where the young men showing great interest in agriculture. I could carry you to John John now. I could carry you in places in Santa Cruz, outside of my constituency, in the said Sobran Trace. I am amazed at the energy and the attraction that these young men in Lavantil are showing for agriculture in circumstances where people think that that is of no interest to them. And they are aware, because I tell them, that state lands, anywhere that they are available in the country, is available to them. Because every week in the cabinet, we approve leases for state lands for agricultural purposes, and it is available to them. My job as MP is to ensure that every single thing that is on offer for the people of Trinidad and Tobago from this great government is available to the people of Lavantil. And they know that. I, like all my member parliament colleagues, will remember when you hear the opposition talk, you will wonder if they feel we like them. We gave out thousands of food cards to people during the heights of the pandemic, valued at $500 and something. I sat there on one day and gave out 52 cards to women who came in great need and who appreciated that. And that was not all. That's in addition to all the $5 billion that the Ministry of Social Development makes available to the people of Trinidad and Tobago, including the people of Lavantil. But more recently, the Prime Minister said to us, all this pacadis and pacadat and salt and sugar are not good for the human body. The science now understands that. So he mandated that we stimulate the agriculture sector in Trinidad and Tobago by ordering from them fresh, green, healthy produce. And we gave out thousands up to Wednesday. We gave out hundreds of those hampers across the constituency of Lavantil West. And all my colleagues and all members of parliament have been doing it. It stimulated the local agriculture sector. It provided healthy support for our citizens, and we are very proud of that. You remember on August the 3rd, there was a major downpour of rain on the city of Port of Spain and around the country. I joined with Member of Parliament Keith Scotland, because I tell you, I don't only see Lavantil West, you know, all is Lavantil. And he and I went in, stronger than me, better looking than me, but we worked hard whole day. Within 48 hours, we boasted. The people couldn't believe it. With the help of the people and the fire service and everyone else, the corporations, we cleaned up the entire place for them in 48 hours. Thank you, Keith Scotland. And it demonstrated to me the spirit and the power of our people and what we could do going forward. And we do that. As for Laventil, I can tell you that all of the major thoroughfares through Laventil, from the old St. Joseph Road to the road from Chinapu to St. Babs, St. Babs down to St. Francois Valley Road, St. Babs down to the Greens on Piccadilly Street, all the road going down to from Laventil Road, Rudolph Charles Link Road down into Gonzales, all the roads in our constituency, that road up by you, where Keith Shepherd used to live down there, what's the name of it? Not by Pittman Lane up so in Gonzales. Coming down to, Augustine Lane, all the roads, all the major thoroughfares, I drove them recently, are well paved and well in order to the joy and happiness. And thanks to the Ministry of Works, we did that. Apart from which, we've had some land slippage issues in Upper Wharton Street. We got the Ministry of Works, the PURE program, they came in, spent some time, did their soil testing, and it is now rehabilitated, and the people could move from Upper Wharton Street into Trumacac with ease and simplicity again today. Similar situation in Stephenville. Joy Benjamin, councillor for the area, would have brought it to our attention, and that too is under construction, rehabilitation as we speak. And of course, Morgan Lane in Harlem, another major road slippage, and we sorted that out for the benefit of the people. We are on the job. As for self-help, up to last week, a woman told me when the rain came, 3 leaks over her kitchen and in the bedroom too. I called the self-help people, the CEO at self-help, Mr. Julian. They are usually there for our people, taking applications, processing them. When money becomes available, they give these grants. All of us as MPs have been handing these out over the years. But on this occasion, recognizing the need, Mr. Julian and his team sprung into action, and within days, the problem was resolved for that constituent, and she's a happy camper indeed. Thanks, self-help. But that's the way we do it in the PNM. We don't steal your money. We don't misuse and abuse your money. We don't allow our friends easy access to the treasury. And as I told Google today on the radio, I really wish that I could allow you, like a fly in the wall in the cabinet room, to see how the Prime Minister, how the Minister of Planning and Development, how the Minister of Finance, and how all of us, by virtue of a strong PNM ethic, how we pinch pennies to make sure that not 1 cent is lost. So when I heard that woman today stumbling through an allegation against the Attorney General about what building he have to rent, I had to say to myself, like, she's, like, something is wrong.
Tired.
Too much walking and running. Johnny and Calamity Jane holding hands. Anyway, she talking today. I know the process we go through. It's not the cabinet decides this alone, you know. The cabinet approves what a ministry brings. The Ministry of Public Administration, there's a specialist unit in there called PRESD, Property and Real Estate Services Division. When you have to rent a property to the government, they have to decide on it. They know how much per square foot. They compare it with other buildings. They match. They make sure the building is of merchantable and occupiable quantities and quality, so to speak. All of that. So I feel proud. They can't point no finger at me or us at all. They can't. What we do could stand scrutiny. And I could tell you, as I close, I too was quite happy when Minister Gonzales called me to tell me that the booster at Pitch Road that Minister Young alluded to was completed. There were 2 pumps there all the pumps that would sometimes break down, and I would know when they break down. I would know when the booster station in Wharton Street breaks down, because I start getting calls from Breeze Hill, from Snake Valley, from St. Barb's. We can't get no water. I call WASA, they will now have to repair it. It takes them a few days. Sometimes they have to get a pump from somewhere. On this occasion, the minister decided that they would do it differently. And what happened? They put in two new submergible pumps alongside the two older ones. They modernized and computerized the system. They put in modern electrical arrangements, and now we have a finely refurbished booster station. One resident from Marie Road, which is now in Stuart Young constituency, I represented there as Laventilis Mova's MP. She came to that forum and told us they had trouble because they live over 500 feet above the level. And now with this pump arrangement, she said water busting pipe up there. I know if Kamala hear that, she will want to go and take up residence in Marie Road, because that's all she know. Pipe, pipe, and more pipe. Folks, I thank you all very warmly. I wish I had more time. I wish I had more time. But I've only given you a hint, a little insight into the love and the care and the concerns we have always had for the people of Laventil. And I conclude by saying, great is the PNM. Great is the PNM, and we must prevail.